All right, we're gonna do an interesting climb today. I hardly ever film climbs, but this one's got some cool technical stuff on it. Pretty steep in sections. Starts off pretty mild like this right here. Very pretty trail. Sees a lot of bike use, but everybody comes downhill on this because going up it is really tough. And it's one of the major touristy stuff that's on the web. Oh, must do. It's a must do. Very pretty day today. I think it's about June 26th. 26th of June, 2020. It's about, about almost two in the afternoon here. You'll see why this is so much fun as a downhill as I get into the big climb up here. Once we go across the little stream up here, the bridge, it kicks up immediately there. Which you can hear the stream now, and there's the bridge. And we're gonna cross it. All right, up we go. I'm always filming downhills on my X1 here, so this will be a little bit different for people that like to watch those videos. Trail gets quite a bit of erosion because so many people come down and skid and loosen the dirt. It was majorly reworked a few years ago, holding up fairly decent to the amount of traffic it gets. I bet on the weekend this trail sees 200 people coming down it. Just a wild ass guess, but based on the number of cars that are always parked in the parking lot there, I'd say that's pretty reasonable. Stick to the insides when I can because people may be coming down. They're gonna take the outside line. Except when I can see around the corners like right now. So, usually you can hear people coming. It's pretty quiet today, except for me talking. The trail builders put all these fun little lips in here. Sheds water, plus gives you a little bit of air time coming down if you hit them right. By the way, I guess this might be the first time I filmed since I got the new Luna 860C meter, which is way better and the stock meter comes with the X1. I can see this one. Plus it's got other features that the stock meter didn't have. Like, it's got battery voltage. With also the dummy generic battery indicator next to it. I like the battery voltage. That's what I keep a track of when I'm on long rides. Getting into a little bit of rocky stuff there. It's also got, you can see the wattage just kick it in. You can see the trip odometer easily. See the ride time easily. Way, way, way better than the meter that comes with the X1. But it's a $100 more for the meter. Got a little bit of a technical stone section here. Gotta remember the line here. I haven't been up here in a while. Usually it's up on the hill up high. Wet, mucky, and slippery. Whew. And on the meter, back to the meter, does have some disadvantages. You can't set the wheel diameter. It's fixed at 27.5, which sucks because this wheel set tire combo I've got is a 27.5 boost set, but wheel diameter is bigger than 27.5. As a consequence of that, your trip mileage will be off as much as 2 miles every 35 miles is about what I've figured out so far. So distance you've ridden is not accurate at all. That's a negative. Another negative is it's not too much to do with the meter, as the M600 motor on the X1 is fixed. You can't program it like you can other Bafang motors. And they don't want you messing with it, I guess. And also, back to the programming for a second, I really would like to divvy up the assist levels a little finer. I have it set to 9 assist levels, and I find 1 too easy, and I use 1, 2, and 3. I'm in 3 right now because that was pretty steep. I'd go down to 2 right now, or 1 actually, for this kind of stuff here. But I gotta get back to work after this ride, so. But anywho, going back up to 3 for this section here. We're almost to the top of this climb. Then it's gonna be a nice downhill. So, not being able to program the assist level sucks. But the bike is so freaking awesome. I'm hoping somebody, one of those little chip guys that is able to get into them and extract the firmware, I'm hoping one of those guys will come along eventually so we could upgrade our firmware. That's mucky. No standing water though. How you doing?
Good.
Hey. Just 2 of us.
Okay, just me. Even though I'm in level 3, I wasn't getting a huge workout on that climb, but if I did it in 2, it might be, well, I know it would be more of a workout, but so I'm saying about programming the assist levels, really would like to set them differently. Not using any more than 3. And if you notice, there's no throttle on this X1. I removed that too. Never use the throttle. And I don't use flat pedals. I'm clipped in. So my pedaling is a round circle pedal where you pull up and push down. So a little more efficient. I'm gonna go down to 1 right here. Just you gotta hold it longer on this, the new meter. You have to hold it longer before it switches this level. There's 1. It still says it's, I don't know, it's not steady, so it's hard to read, but it's 200 and some. I wouldn't want any more than about 50 to 75 watts on level 1. And then make level 2 up to about 100-150. And level 3 could be about where level 1 is right now. Then I could divvy it up finer and use 1 to 5 instead of 1 to 3. But just wishful thinking right now. All right. We're gonna go through a section about like this for a little bit. Crest a tiny hill top, and then have an awesome downhill. Nothing really technical. It's an old grassy road, logging road. So, but being as it's wet like this, the dirt is. It's almost perfect right now. As long as you don't hit any muck holes and go sideways like that right there, should get a pretty good tire bite today. Because when this really dry, you could be having a bad day in a turn if you don't do it right. Almost to the crest of the little hill right up here where it tips down. Woo! I do have to be careful. Have to make sure I can see around corners because a lot of people come up this to get to that downhill we just climbed. But it's on a Thursday afternoon. Shouldn't be too crowded here. The weekend, forget about it. All right, here we go. Rider up. Walker up. Hi.
Hi.
How you doing today?
Good.
Have a good one.
Are you by yourself?
Yep, I am. All right, first slow down. I just barely got a hint of her clothing looking right through the weeds there back there. If you're not paying attention, you could easily come around that corner and then scare the shit out of them, and that ain't good. A couple of these corners are real tight coming out. It's almost a huge slowdown. Get back out of the corner. Oh, there's a new dead tree since the last time I was here. Right here's a corner that I slow down for because it is impossible to see around that corner. And I've caught people right there before. In the wintertime, this is one of those corners you have to really slow down for. In wintertime, when all the leaves are off, except for the rhododendron, you can see around the corners, no problem. By the way, I'm an assist level 1 this whole downhill right here. These long straightaways you can see pretty good around the corners there. Here I can look around the corner and see way down the trail, so it's go time. But this next corner looking good there, looking right there, we go, I can see the straightaway now. Here's a good spot to, I can't see around this corner very well. Now I can look right a long ways over there. Ooh, rock hit my foot. Let's see here. Here's one of those corners that are hard to get through fast. Expert downhillers can, but I am not one of them. Hi. How you doing?
Good.
Good, just me. Have fun, girls. All right. She made a squawking noise. All right. We're done. All right, I got another section or two to do here. I'm just gonna call that a wrap right there. And it's cut.